Today I'm going to talk to you about my tomato hole planting recipe. And I'm really excited about today's episode because I love tomatoes and I'm always super excited to get my first tomatoes planted in the ground. So we're going to be planting a couple tomatoes today. The first one is the San Marzano tomato, which I have not grown before, but I have heard wonderful things about this variety. It's a great, super meaty tomato for sauces, for all kinds of things, and I'm really excited to grow this in my garden. The second tomato, which is probably my all-time favorite, I got the seeds from Praxis a couple years ago. It's a yellow cherry tomato, and this tomato is amazing. It's super sweet. It tastes like candy. You can literally eat them by the handfuls. So two of my favorite kind of tomatoes, I'm going to get them planted today. Now what I do when I plant my tomatoes, I've got my holes dug right here in my garden bed, and I have dug my holes right next to my drip hose, which you probably can't see that, but that way the tomatoes get good deep watering in the heat of the summer. But first I'm going to add a handful of compost to each hole. Now this is compost I made here on site, and you can go back and watch my hot composting video if you want to see how I made it. But it just smells wonderfully rich. It's beautiful dark compost. I'm going to go ahead and add a handful to each hole. Now the second thing I'm going to add is about a tablespoon of Epsom salts. Now, I have added Epsom salts every year that I've planted tomatoes, and my tomatoes have always done wonderfully for me. Now, Epsom salt is basically magnesium sulfate. It really helps the plant take up all the nutrients from the soil, helps the plant take up chlorophyll, and it really helps in fruit production. I like to mix it into my planting hole every time I plant, as well as add it to the base of my tomatoes throughout the growing season. Now, the second thing I'm adding this year is a little handful of crushed eggshells. Now I've been saving eggshells all winter long. I have a couple of bags of them crushed up in the freezer just for this day. But the eggshells are going to add some calcium to my tomato planting hole, and calcium is what's going to help the tomatoes help prevent blossom end rot on the tomatoes. Now if you don't know what blossom end rot is, it's where the bottom of the tomato just gets kind of brownish and the tomato is just kind of mushy, and basically this is caused from a calcium deficiency. So since eggshells have a lot of calcium in them, this is going to help my tomatoes a lot when it comes to blossom end rot. So I just put maybe a tablespoon or so in each hole. Now the third thing I'm going to add this year, and I got this tip from Gary Pilarchik, so make sure you check out his YouTube page. He has an awesome, awesome YouTube page with all kinds of videos for first-time gardeners. I'm going to add an aspirin to each hole. Now, you might be saying, wow, this is kind of strange. Why are you going to add an aspirin to your tomato planting hole? Well, the reason why I'm doing this is because the salicylic acid in an aspirin triggers a hormone in a tomato, which triggers a defense mechanism. So it will help the tomato get ready to fight off disease when disease hits. So I just put one little baby aspirin, actually. These are baby aspirin. And I'm going to crush it up and just put one of those crushed up baby aspirin into each planting hole as well. Just pour it right in there. And you can also dissolve this in water if you want to. And this is also good to spray on your plants every couple of weeks throughout the growing season to help your tomato plants fight off disease. So I've got those three things added. My tomato hole planting recipe, I'm just gonna kind of mix them around with the compost in each hole. And we're ready to plant our tomatoes. Okay, first I'm gonna go ahead and plant the yellow cherry. Actually, I think this is the San Marzano. Now I started these in little peat pellets inside the house. They've been actually outdoors hardening off for a week or so. If you don't know what hardening off is, it's just a gradual process of getting them used to being outdoors before they go outdoors for good. Now these peat pellets have a little netting around them. Some people plant them with the netting, but I really like to take it off. And you can see there's some really awesome roots here. I like to take it off very carefully. Some of the roots do end up tearing, but that's okay. I've never had a problem with a tomato growing because I took off the netting. So I take this netting off because it really doesn't break down and biodegrade very easily like it says on the package. So I just take that off, and I'm going to bury the tomato stem all the way up to the leaf here because tomatoes will put out roots wherever the stem touches the dirt. So pretty simple. I'm going to go ahead and put this in my hole here. Add some compost around it.
to fill in the hole. It's pretty simple. Now, usually I transplant my tomatoes into a bigger container before I plant them outdoors, but I wanted to try it this year for a couple of reasons. Number one, it's a whole lot easier to dig a hole for a tiny little peat pellet than for a larger pot. When I'm planting, you know, 15 or 20 tomato plants, it just takes a lot, and it's a lot quicker. And the second thing is, I wanted to get them in as soon as I possibly could so I could have tomatoes as soon as possible. Okay, there we go. There we go. My first tomato of the year is planted, and I can't wait to taste those wonderful tomatoes. I'm just gonna go ahead and plant the other one here and get these tomatoes caged up, and we'll come back and show you how they look. Okay, so there you have it. I've got my tomato cages in. Oh, and by the way, you want to see how I made these tomato cages, I'll put a link at the end of this video to how I made my tomato cages. I'm actually reusing these for the second year. So we're just watering these tomatoes, and I am watering them with the hose, but normally I will water them with my soaker hose. And I'm so excited, my first tomatoes of the season planted in the ground, and it's not even April 1st yet. So there you have it. If you have any other things that you'd like to add to your tomato planting holes, please leave me a comment below, because I know there's lots of different ways to do it. So thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you next time.